Hi, I'm Connie Frigo. I'm the baritone saxophonist with the New Century Saxophone Quartet. I'm also the saxophone professor at the University of Tennessee in Knoxville, where I have a studio of about 18 undergraduates and graduate students. What I'd like to speak with you about today is the use of your air when you're playing the saxophone. It's true that the baritone saxophone requires a little bit more air than the other horns, the tenor, alto, and the soprano. However, it's really, really important that you use a very, very fast stream of air whenever you're playing any of the saxophones. And one way to build your endurance and condition your use of air is to play long tones. And every single practice session that I have starts with long tones. And just for example, a long tone could be that you hold a note for 8 counts, or you simply hold it as long as you can till your air runs out. And I would continue doing that for probably up to 10 minutes. Another thing that I do for building the use of my air and endurance is to run my scales in extended range of the saxophone to the highest note of the saxophone all the way down to the lowest note at a reasonable tempo and try to do it all in one breath. And when you're able to pick up some speed, try running that 2 times in one breath. I have a little bit easier time doing that when I play alto saxophone because it doesn't take as much air as the baritone. But one of the most important things you need to remember when you're playing any of the saxophones, as you go lower into the range of the saxophone, toward the low C, toward the low B flat keys, you have to increase your air speed and volume of air. If you don't, you're going to get this kind of sound. Sounds like you're decrescendoing down to the low end of the horn. Instead, increase your air as though you're beginning to talk louder. Have that kind of pressure come from the back of your throat. Then you fill out the sound really nicely, and you get the maximum sound out of the saxophone. If you continue playing with weak air, you're going to have response problems in the low end of the horn. So my best advice, more air, faster air, quicker air, and I think you'll be on to a great sound. Thanks a lot.